Welcome to the Thursday, November 29th, 2012 edition of Erner Berry's Daily Video, sponsored today by Eastern Poultry and Food Distributors. In today's video, we look at the state of the Pangasius market, and later find out how supplies of frozen chicken wing and legs could impact the market. Now let's look at the markets with your host, Jamie Chadwick.
Quaker Steak and Lube has signed an area development agreement with Salt and Pepper Restaurants Incorporated for four new restaurants throughout Houston, Texas, and the surrounding cities, with the restaurants planned to open in 2013. Furthermore, Quaker Steak and Lube is on track to open 12 restaurants this year and another 12 in 2013. The brand has signed development agreements in six new markets with five new franchise groups. The company currently has close to 60 locations open across 18 states and Canada. For more on Quaker Steak's expansion plans and for other Center of the Plate protein news, check out foodmarket.com. Now here's Seafood.com news staff writer Michael Ramsing with an analysis of the 2012 Pangasius market as U.S. imports continue their record year.
The Pangasius, or SWI, market is the epitome of the fundamental laws of supply and demand for at least 2012. Imports over the past few years have grown exponentially, from roughly 3 million pounds in 2005 to 194 million pounds in 2011. This year-to-date figures show an increase of 25% in imports of frozen fillets when compared to 2011, equivalent to 35 million more pounds. If we keep everything else constant, this would suggest a drop in prices by approximately the same proportion. However, this is seldom true. Average prices for Pangasius have fallen approximately 14% from $2.03 per pound in January to $1.75 per pound in late November. Replacement costs have also adjusted lower 11% from $1.61 per pound in January to $2.43 per pound in September. In addition to lower replacement costs, market insiders have reported weakness in the market, mostly due to plentiful inventories. While some have attributed the weakness to declining demand in Europe, which, again, keeping everything else equal, would have resulted in excess product in search of a home. Though a floor price was set to be in place in Vietnam, according to reports released during the summer, the market has dictated otherwise. Meanwhile, the market is currently oversupplied, yet one assumption can be made. Even though imports are 25% higher, prices have only adjusted roughly 14% downward. Hence, we can safely assume that demand is increasing, just not at the pace supply has. For an in-depth look at the Pangasius market, check out our November 2012 Aquaculture Insiders Report by clicking World Trade under the Seafood tab in Comtel.
Thanks, Michael. Now here's Erner Berry market reporter Russell Barton looking at the USDA's latest cold storage report and what elevated inventories of chicken wings and legs could mean for the market heading into 2013.
The USDA's cold storage figures were released recently and portrayed an interesting turn of events. Each of the categories from 2012 are below last year levels in terms of pounds, with the exception of legs and wings. Leg inventories have been tracked above year-ago totals since the second quarter, but the adjustment made by wings has taken place only over the last 2 months. The most recent figures reveal a 37% advance in this arena. Industry theories on why this scenario has taken place most often involve the price point of wings. Currently, the value of wings is 42 cents per pound above the same day in 2011, a circumstance that has been very similar throughout 2012. With that in mind, the last time these conditions existed, buyers reacted in a very frugal manner, resulting in similarly elevated storage levels. Looking forward, the current price of wings is well supported for the time being, but high market values may result in nervous buying patterns and concurrently higher storage stocks, particularly if history is any indication.
Thanks, Russell. That wraps up today's video. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.
This broadcast is sponsored by Eastern Poultry and Food Distributors, wholesalers of poultry, beef, pork, and seafood since 1954. Visit them online at epoultry.com.